exciting because it's my first exhibition and fun. A huge thank you to Aaron because I did one of his Indigenous music and media courses last year, and that inspired the concept of Kanamar Hall. The concept of that is whole work, which is Kanamar, which is an Indigenous concept of like two rivers meeting to create a deeper knowledge of a pool, deeper pool of water creating deep knowledge. That's making sense, but I wrote it on a sheet of paper, so so another thanks to Jason O'Brien, who I don't think is here right now, but he helped set up the whole space, and he's in charge of photo space, so thank you to him for letting us use this area. Thank you to my parents and family for supporting me, and also thank you to all my subjects who allowed me to photograph them. And, so really, the whole idea behind this is to portray two sides of the person. So you have the use of multi-exposure photography. It's used to demonstrate those two personalities of that person and then working together. So you have to take a deeper look into that person to fully understand them. And it's all about, we use music as well because it adds another level of understanding and connects everyone together. That's how everyone works. You can't be a person in isolation. Would you like to say something about music?
Yeah, just as a base concept, the idea is that each portrait itself has a voice, which is its own piece of music, but as with the drum, I think they're everything comes together to make a whole, and each portrait will converse with the others. So music will come in and come out as the conversation changes between the portraits.
I think the interesting thing about this exhibition is that Rose, for us at the Australian National University School of Music, exemplifies a kind of student who we want to support, somebody who can actually conceive of an entire project from beginning to end, not just be one part of it, but in effect be over all parts of it, and also collaborate with other people. So when Rose had this idea for this exhibition late last year, I said, well, there are these, hollow courses that enable you to do free range creative projects. They don't have to be strictly musical, they can include music, but they can include a lot of other things as well. And so the idea for this was born. Obviously, we're processing them tonight. So, hands up if we pay money to see this. Anybody?
Well, that's over 90 then. Great. I'm not pre-empting them. The interesting thing I think about Rose's approach to this, having worked on with her on a few projects now, including our Indigenous Music Symposium last year, and also the work she does as a sound archiving intern at the Institute of Aboriginal Studies down on Acton Peninsula, is that she brings to all of her projects a real sense of how everything fits together and then is able to manage the various parts of that to create something that we all walk into and see as an integrated whole that looks like it's so easy to pull off because it's so well managed, but actually it's very, very hard. And I can think about the conversations we had, for example, about making the sound work in a space like this. In fact, that's even before we knew that we would have this space, which of course Rose went and found all on her own. And the kinds of solutions that she was able to come up with, like using this basic domestic speakers, as you see before you, actually adds, I think, an incredible authenticity to what's going on here. Is, these are the kinds of, sound devices you'd find in these people's bedrooms. So, I think that you two have done a great job. Thank you very much. It's pretty much all been done without me, which is pretty impressive, really. And I think also that the things that we find in exhibitions like this, you know, continually, I think, challenge what it is that we think about the way that students coming through organisations, institutions like this one, can be engaged not just with their, you know, home arts practice, if you like, but also with other artists and across all the arts. So in that respect, thanks to the to Jason and the School of Art for actually providing this place, because we really appreciate it. And I think, yeah, I think this is a really great example of where this can go down the track. So thanks a lot. Thank you.